Can we have some glitter?
Please!
Oh, all right. But only if you all promise to be very, very careful with it.
We promise!
Okay, I will unlock the glitter cabinet.
Madame Gazelle keeps the glitter safely locked away.
Now, children, you did promise to use this glitter very carefully.
It is home time, and the parents have come to collect the children.
Ah! Glitter!
Don't panic! Please remain calm. There was a glitter leak, but we have it under control now. Today, the children have been making masks.
Ooh!
Ho, ho! I'm here to pick up Peppa and George, but I can't see them anywhere.
I'm a pretty butterfly. Flutter, flutter, flutter!
Excuse me, Mrs. Butterfly. I'm looking for two little piggies. Do you know where I can find them?
Daddy, I tricked you. It's me.
Peppa, what a surprise. But where is George? George, it's you. I thought you were a dinosaur.
Madame Gazelle, I can't find Rebecca and Richard. Would you mind if I took these two carrots home instead?
Silly, Mummy. It's us.
Oh, Rebecca, Richard.
Come on, Pedro. Time to go home.
I am not Pedro. I am Super Pony.
Oh, does Super Pony want to come home? Or does Super Pony want to stay here for the night?
Come home with you, please, Mummy.
Haven't we all had fun making wonderful masks?
Who are you?
It is I, Madame Gazelle.
Madame Gazelle loves masks. Everyone loves masks.
Did you know you could jump really high on the moon?
Oh, how high?
As high as a house.
Why can you jump so high on the moon? The gravitational pull is smaller on the moon.
Oh, yes, that's it. They're quite the clever clogs, aren't we?
Edmund Elephant is a clever clogs.
I was a little bit lonely up there, with just the moon and the stars. And the most exciting bit was...
What's the most exciting bit, Grampy Rabbit?
I can't hear you. Why has he stopped talking?
Oh, dear. Grampy Rabbit has lost his voice. I had better ring Dr. Brown Bear.
Dr. Brown Bear speaking.
Hello, Dr. Brown Bear. Grampy Rabbit has lost his voice.
Is that such a bad thing?
Yes. He's giving an important talk about space rockets to the children.
Oh, in that case, I'll be straight there. Hello, Grampy Rabbit. I hear you've lost your voice. Say ah, please. I see. Yes, a very serious case of losing a voice. Too much shouting, I imagine. Let's see if a little bit of medicine helps. Open wide. Try saying ah now. Louder.
Ah! That's better! Not back to normal! They're getting there!
Hooray!
Now, where was I?
You were just about to tell us the most exciting bit.
Oh, yes! The most exciting bit was I wrote a song. Would you like to hear it?
No, thank you.
Yes, please!
I got up this morning.
Peppa has found a top hat. Danny Dog has found some spotty trunks and a stick-on moustache. Pedro has found a clown outfit.
Who wants makeup?
Me, please.
What does everyone want to be? I want to be the clown.
But Peppa, where is your clown costume?
Okay, you be the clown.
I want to be the strong man.
Okay, Danny, you be the strong man.
I want to be the juggler.
But I wanted to do that.
Wow!
Okay, you be the juggler. Grandpa, I don't have a job to do.
You can be the ringmaster, Peppa. You've got the hat for it.
What's a ringmaster?
The ringmaster is the boss.
Yes! I'll be the ringmaster. What do I do?
You say, "Welcome to my circus. See the impossible, the amazing, the incredible feats of daring do."
Ooh. Welcome to my circus. It's got amazing feet.
Moo!
Granny Pig's garden party guests are here.
Hello, everyone. You're in for a treat. The circus has come to town.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my circus. Now, please be very scared of the amazing Candy Cat. Look at George, Richard and Edmund on tricycles! Don't stop clapping, it's the strong Danny dog!
I was a strong man once. I used to lift tractors.
Ice creams for everyone. The cafe should be just about here. Oh.
Where's the cafe? Is it behind that rotten pile of wood?
I think that rotten pile of wood is the cafe.
Oh. There's not going to be any ice creams coming out of that today.
Hello. What can I get you?
Oh.
A cup of coffee and 3 ice creams, please.
Of course.
Thank you.
Mmm, delicious.
Next stop, the fish pond. This way.
Oh, you don't want to go that way. That goes straight into a blackberry bush.
Aha! It's the shortcut. It's the way I went when I was a boy.
No, if you want to go to the fish pond, you need to go up that path.
Well, I'm taking the shortcut.
All right. Who wants to go through a blackberry bush?
Me.
And who wants to go on the path?
Me. Race you, Daddy.
Ho, ho. I'll get there first.
Bye.
I hope the fish pond is still here.
Yes. Everything seems a bit different to what Daddy remembers.
What's that?
It's the fish pond.
George, let's see the little fish. Oh, Daddy said that the fish were tiny. But they're ginormous.
It's been a long time since Daddy was here. The fish have got a lot bigger.
Like Daddy's tummy. Oh, where is Daddy?
Oh, he might be lost. I'd better ring him.
There's a phone ringing in that bush.
Hello, Mr. Pig speaking.
It's Daddy.
Oh, hello. I'm stuck.
Hello, Daddy.
Hang on, we'll pull you out. 1, 2, 3, pull.
Daddy is a blackberry bush.
Ah, the fish pond. Let's see the little fish. Whoa, that's a big fish.
Oh, look. There's something glittering.
Who do you think that is?
It's Baby Alexander.
Baby Alexander is Peppa's cousin.
No, that's you as a baby Peppa.
Baby Peppa.
Somebody sounds like they're having fun.
Look, Daddy. That's a picture of me as a baby.
I remember it well. It was taken on our first day in this house.
What do you mean?
When you were little, we moved into this house. We brought all our things on top of our car. Mummy Pig put some pictures up.
Daddy Pig put up a shelf. And Grandpa Pig made us a lovely flower garden.
Where's Grandpa's lovely flower garden now?
Daddy Pig looked after it.
We had the wrong kind of soil for flowers.
Oh.
And anyway, you needed somewhere to play.
You and Suzy loved to play in the garden.
Was Suzy my friend in the olden days?
Yes, you and Suzy have always been best friends.
In the olden days, did Suzy and me jump up and down in muddy puddles?
No, Peppa. You were babies. You couldn't even walk.
Oh, what did we do?
You cried. You burped. And you laughed.
We were babies.
Baby Suzy.
Baby Peppa.
Goo goo gaga goo goo gaga.
Soon after that, you were toddlers.
And where was George?
He was a baby in my tummy. Yes, you were in my tummy, George.
Please.
Very well.
That was amazing.
Yes, I was the world champion at skiing and won this cup.
Ooh.
Now, which mummy or daddy would like a go? Why not?
Are you sure, Mummy Pig? You haven't skied for years.
It's just like riding a bike, Daddy Pig. You never forget. Here is the baby slope, Mummy Pig.
I think I'm a bit grown up for the baby slope.
Which way does this go?
Ah! All the way down the mountain!
My mummy is skiing down the mountain!
Ah! Where are the brakes? Oh, she can't stop! We have to catch up with her! Ah! Stand back!
Mummy Pig is skiing along the road!
Ah!
Everyone is in the coach, chasing after Mummy Pig.
Wow! My mummy is skiing super fast! Mummy, did I loop the loop?
That was fantastic skiing!
Mummy Pig is skiing past the shops.
Yeah! Ah! How am I going to stop?
My goodness, a walking, talking snowman.
No, it's just my mummy.
I have never seen such amazing skiing. This cup belongs to you.
Thank you.
My mummy is the best at skiing down the mountain.
Whoops, whoa!
Miss Rabbit has tripped over one of Richard's toys.
Oh, my ankle. I can still hop to work. No, stay here and get better.
But I've got so much work to do.
I'll do your work for you. Which job is first?
The supermarket.
OK, Rebecca, look after your auntie.
Yes, Mummy.
Mummy Rabbit has arrived at the supermarket.
Thank goodness you're here, Miss Rabbit.
Miss Rabbit is ill. I'll be doing her job today.
Are you not Miss Rabbit?
No, I'm her sister, Mummy Rabbit. Is this where I sit?
Yes. Have you ever worked a checkout before?
No.
How much is this?
Oh, I don't know.
I've got a voucher.
Do you take book tokens?
Can I pay with a card?
Suzy Sheep is dressed up in her nurse's costume.
Don't worry, I'm only a pretend nurse. Stick your tongue out and say, ah.
Ah.
Rebecca Rabbit's house. Who's speaking, please?
It's Mummy Rabbit. Is everything okay?
Yes.
Good, because this job is going to take me all day.
What about Miss Rabbit's other jobs?
We'll need more help.
Miss Rabbit's ice cream stall.
Daddy, why are you buying an ice cream?
Oh, Peppa, I was on the way to the gym when I thought an ice cream would be nice.
Miss Rabbit is ill. You've got to sell the ice cream today.
Oh, oh, I'm an expert at ice cream.
Can I have a cherry ice cream?
Strawberry, vanilla, chocolate, banana.
With pistachio and strawberry, please.
Ah, strawberry. Oh, it's melted. How about ice cream soup instead?
Is that everyone?
We haven't seen you yet.
I am sorry. What is your name?
I'm Peppa Pig. We've met before.
Ah, yes. Nice to see you again, Peppa. What would you like for Christmas?
I would like a doll that walks and talks and closes its eyes when it goes to sleep. Please.
The same for me, please.
Very good.
You do know where I live, don't you?
Oh, yes.
How old are you?
Oh, I'm hundreds of years old.
I told you.
Goodbye, Father Christmas.
Don't forget to leave me a mince pie
and a drink. We know.
And a carrot for the reindeer.
Ho, ho, ho.
Peppa and her family are driving back from the Christmas fair.
Daddy, why have we got our bags in the car?
We're spending Christmas at Granny and Grandpa's house.
But Father Christmas won't know where we are.
Don't worry, Peppa. Father Christmas knows everything.
Granny Pig, it's nearly Christmas.
Yes, and I've got a very important job for you. Stir the Christmas pudding and make a wish.
Peppa and George are making a wish.
Racing car.
Oh, don't tell me what it is.
Here's the mince pie and a drink for Father Christmas.
And a carrot for the reindeer.
Who can that be at this time of night? We're not buying anything.
Merry joyful greetings, festive happy cheer.
Carol singers.
Snow is falling gently, Christmas time.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
It is bedtime for Peppa and George.
This used to be my bedroom when I was a little piggy.
Father Christmas knows where Granny and Grandpa live, doesn't he?
Oh, yes. He's been here many times before. Good night, Peppa. Good night, George.
Peppa and George have fallen asleep. When they wake up.
That's just a drawing.
Yes. Now you must run to the real Windy Castle.
Oh.
Ready, steady, go.
Hooray!
Come on, Daddy Pig! You can make it!
The school bus has made it to Windy Castle. Now everyone can enjoy the picnic.
Water! Water!
What a lovely hot day! And such a relaxing way to raise money, too.
Water! Water!
Daddy Pig has reached the supermarket. All the running has made him very thirsty.
Let's look through the telescope.
I can see Daddy.
The telescope makes everything look closer.
Oh, he's not going very fast.
Daddy Pig has arrived at Grandad Dog's garage.
That's it. I can't go on.
Daddy has stopped.
Oh.
You look rather hot. You need something to cool you down and give you energy. Have an ice lolly.
Thank you, Grandad Dog. That's nice. Ah, a wasp. Shoo, shoo. Get away, you little pest.
The wasp wants to share Daddy Pig's ice lolly.
No! This is my lolly.
Daddy started running again, really fast.
Hooray!
Ah, get off! Get off!
You can stop now, Daddy Pig. We have enough money to fix the school roof.
Ah!
Daddy Pig has lost the wasp.
Well done, Daddy Pig. All that extra running means we've got enough money for a new school bus, too.
Thank you, Daddy Pig.
You're most welcome.
The washing machine is making the whole room shake.
Oh, Peppa, where's your dress?
I'm washing it.
What? Oh, no.
Look, Mummy. My red dress is all nice and clean.
Yes, Peppa, but look what it's done to everything else.
Oh, dear. Peppa's red dress has made all the white clothes pink.
Pink isn't a very good colour for a football shirt.
Ooh.
Daddy Pig is home from work.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Daddy.
Daddy Pig, we've got a bit of a problem and,
Tell me later, Mummy Pig. I've got to get ready for football. Now, where's my football shirt?
Here.
Don't be silly, Peppa. That's one of Mummy's dresses. It's pink.
No, Daddy. It's your football shirt.
It got a bit muddy.
So we washed it.
And it all went a bit wrong. Sorry, Daddy.
But I can't wear a pink football shirt.
Why not, Daddy? Pink is a lovely colour.
Hmm. What do you think, George?
Yuck.
George does not like pink. Here are Daddy Pig's friends, Mr. Bull, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Pony and Mr. Zebra.
Moo! Is Daddy Pig coming out to play?
He'll just be a moment.
My team are in white. I need a white shirt.
But, Daddy, you have a white shirt. Just take off your jacket. See?
Fantastic! Thank you, Peppa. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Daddy Pig.
Like your shirt.
Very smart.
Thank you. Come on, let's play football.
Yes!
Go!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Daddy, you've made your shirt all muddy.
Of course, Peppa. Football shirts are meant to be muddy.
Daddy Pig loves playing football. Everyone loves playing football, especially when it's muddy.
If I take this rubber duck and hide it where you can see it, do you think you could find it?
Daddy, if we can see it, you haven't hidden it.
Watch this. I will put the duck here. Now, you tell me where it is.
There.
Exactly.
It's too easy, Daddy.
It won't always be so easy, Peppa.
Who wants to go first?
Because it's an easy game, George can go first.
Okay, you all wait here.
Daddy Pig is putting the rubber duck somewhere for George to find.
The duck is somewhere in your bedroom.
George is looking for the rubber duck. But it is quite difficult to find.
Oh.
George, you can see it. Just look with your eyes.
George is using his eyes to look for the rubber duck.
You're getting warmer. Colder. Warm again.
George has found the rubber duck.
Hooray!
I saw it straight away. This game is too easy.
Okay, Peppa's turn. I will do the hiding this time.
Mummy Pig is going to put the rubber duck somewhere for Peppa to find.
I will see it straight away.
Ready!
The rubber duck is somewhere in the kitchen.
I've come to find you, rubber ducky. I know where you are. You're in the sink. Oh.
The rubber duck is not in the sink.
I know. You're hiding under the table.
The rubber duck is not under the table.
Give me a clue, please.
It's sitting with something else that's yellow.
Something yellow that lives in the kitchen. Bananas! There you are! Mummy Rabbit, is there really a baby rabbit in your tummy?
Yes. Would you like to listen to it?
Yes, please.
Can you hear a little heartbeat?
Yes, I can. It's going boom, boom, boom. Oh, it just moved.
Yes. Sometimes babies give a little kick.
Nay.
What will you call it?
I don't know. Would you children like to think of a name?
Yes, please.
Hello, Mummy Rabbit. Would you like a cup of coffee?
I can't have coffee, but I am quite hungry.
Would you like a carrot?
I'm a bit off carrots. Have you got any potatoes?
Yes, we do.
Maybe a potato with jelly and cheese and strawberry jam, please.
A potato with jelly, cheese and strawberry jam? What a funny mixture of food.
We need to think of a name for the baby.
Yes, if the baby is a girl, she'll be called Rachel Rabbit.
Or how about Ruth Rabbit?
Roxanne Rabbit.
Sharon Rabbit. I don't think so, Pedro.
Sharon Rabbit sounds wrong.
I like Rosie.
Rosie Rabbit. It's perfect.
But what if the baby is a boy?
Oh.
How about Rufus Rabbit?
Raymond Rabbit.
Michael Rabbit.
Michael Rabbit? No!
Robbie Rabbit.
Yes, Robbie Rabbit.
Thank you for the potatoes with jelly, cheese and strawberry jam, Mummy Pig.
My pleasure.
We thought of a name for the baby.
Rosie if it's a girl and Robbie if it's a boy.
They're lovely names.
It's sad that the baby can't have both names.
Oh, my tummy.
It's all that funny food you've been eating.
I don't think so, Daddy Rabbit. The baby is coming.
Right, to the hospital. Quickly now, don't panic.
Bye.
I don't think it's that big red button, George. That would be too obvious. Oh.
Yes, we try to keep it simple.
This is fun.
This passage has led us to the dining hall.
Wow!
This must be the medieval banquet.
Yes, it looks really tasty.
It's all made of plastic.
Yes, it's to show what a real banquet would have looked like.
Oh.
But of course, as part of the tour, you get to have your very own real medieval banquet.
Fantastic!
Here it is, your banquet in a box. The oldie cheese sandwich, jester's pickle and a king's jelly.
It's a little picnic in a box.
Yes, it's not quite the medieval banquet I was expecting.
And now it's time to meet the dragon.
George, it won't be a real dragon. Dragons are just pretend.
Yes, don't be sad if it's just Miss Rabbit holding a little glove puppet. Oh.
Wow.
Miss Rabbit is driving a huge robot dragon.
Do you want to see it breathe fire?
Yes, please.
I'm just going to park it.
It's heading for our car.
Another reason we say cars are parked at owner's risk.
And that's the end of the tour.
Hope you had a lovely time.
I think that was George's best day out ever.
George loves castles. Everyone loves castles.
thinks their mummy or daddy would like to do a parachute jump.
My mummy.
My daddy.
We need just one.
Peppa and George have arrived back home.
Mummy, the school roof is leaking again.
Is it, darling?
Yes. Madam Gazelle says it needs a lot of money to mend.
Yes, I'm sure it does.
She asked if somebody's mummy or daddy would jump out of an aeroplane.
Oh, I hope you didn't say daddy would do it, Peppa. You know he doesn't like heights.
But you don't mind heights, do you, Mummy?
I'm fine with heights.
Good.
Oh. Thank you, Mummy Pig, for agreeing to jump from an aeroplane.
What? But I've never done it before.
You'll be fine. Remember, it is for the children.
Oh, in that case, of course I'll do it.
Hooray for Mummy Pig!
It is the day of Mummy Pig's parachute jump.
I'm still not sure I really want to do this.
It's all in a good cause, Mummy Pig.
But I don't know how to jump out of an aeroplane.
Don't worry, you'll get lots of training first.
Hello, Mummy Pig. Mr. Rabbit is the parachute trainer. This is a parachute. It will help you float through the air after you jump.
Should I practice that?
Practice what?
Jumping.
Why not? There, you're a natural.
Is that it?
Yes, you are now fully trained.
Hooray!
All aboard!
I'm still a tiny bit worried about this jump, Daddy Pig.
It's okay, Mummy Pig. I'll come up in the plane with you.
Good luck, Mummy!
Don't worry, Mummy Pig. Remember, you've got a parachute.
Yes, Daddy Pig.
Oh, we are a long way from the ground.
Oh, dear. Oh. Daddy Pig has fallen out of the plane.
There she goes. No, wait, that's Daddy Pig.
There, Peppa. That's how tall you are.
I'm taller than I was before.
That's because you're growing up, Peppa.
Now George's turn. There, George. That's how tall you are.
I am taller than George.
Oh.
Don't worry, George. As you get older, you'll get taller.
Yes, but I will always be taller than you, George, because I will always be older.
It is time for playgroup.
Children, today a new friend is joining our playgroup. Say hello to Gerald.
Hello, Gerald!
Hello!
Wow, you're really tall, so you must be really old.
No, Gerald is the same age as you.
Why is he so tall then?
I'm tall because I'm a giraffe.
I'm taller.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. You measure to the top of the ears. Oh, do ears count?
Gerald Giraffe is the tallest.
Oh. I wish I was as tall as Gerald.
And me.
And me.
And me. And me.
It is playtime.
Let's play hide and seek.
Okay. One, two.
While Peppa counts to 10, everyone must find a hiding place.
7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not? Here I come. Found you, Gerald.
Oh. You didn't find me.
Or me.
Or me.
Or me.
Or me. I always get found because I'm so tall.
Oh.
It's not much fun being tall. I have to bend down to talk to everyone.
I have to bend down to talk to George. Hello, George. What's it like being little?
That's a lot of shopping.
It's everything on Granny Pig's list. Where's the car?
I didn't bring the car. I didn't think you'd be buying so much.
Oh, I'll call for a taxi.
Hello, taxi service. A taxi will be with you shortly. Sorry, I'm just popping out. Back in a mo. Taxi service! Where are you going?
Granny and Grandpa Pig's house, please.
Righty-ho, hop in! I see you've been shopping. Lots of shopping about these days. Shopping for this, shopping for that. Shopping, shopping,
Miss Rabbit, why are you talking so much?
It's what taxi drivers do, Peppa.
Ah.
Mind you, I had Mr. Potato in the back of the car the other day. I thought he'd be...
Granny Pig is going away for a few days. Grandpa Pig will be on his own.
This is a tin of food. To get the food out, you will need this. It's a tin opener.
I know what it is, Granny Pig.
If you want to boil an egg, fill a pan full of water,
Yes, I know.
Granny Pig!
Hello, my little ones. We've got the shopping. But why are you not at the airport, Granny? Oh, yes. I'd better call a taxi.
Taxi service. Hello, Granny Pig.
I'd like to go to the airport, please.
Of course. Hop in.
Thank you.
Daddy, can we wave Granny goodbye at the airport?
OK.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Going to the airport, are you?
Yes. And actually, we're in a bit of a hurry.
Hurry in here, hurry in there. Why are people always in a hurry?
Granny Pig has a plane to catch.
She's going on holiday.
Holiday? I never have time to go on holiday. I'm too busy being in a hurry.
Miss Rabbit, are you talking like a taxi driver again?
Yes.
The taxi has arrived at the airport.
Goodbye, my little ones.
Bye-bye, Granny. Bye-bye.
Peppa and George are waving Granny Pig goodbye. Here is Mr. Wolf.
Taxi!
Hop in.
Bye-bye, Mr. Wolf.
Peppa and George love waving goodbye.
Bye-bye. Daddy, how are we getting home?
In the taxi. Oh, it's gone.
Been on holiday, have you?
I'm actually very tired. Do you mind if we don't talk?
Talk? Yes, people talk too much these days, don't they? Talk, 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 talk.
Oh, no!
What's the matter, Peppa?
My tyre has gone flat.
It's only a puncture. I'm a bit of an expert at mending punctures. First, we take off the wheel. Next, we take the tyre off the wheel.
Are you coming, Peppa?
Then we need a bucket of water.
Can you do it quickly, Daddy?
I won't be long, Peppa. While you wait, you could pretend to ride a bicycle.
Pretend?
Yes, your very own pretend bicycle.
Okay, I have thought of a very nice bike. I'm riding my bicycle. La 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 la.
Why are you walking, Funny?
I'm not walking, Suzy.
Where's your bicycle?
It's here. It's a pretend bicycle. It's got sparkly wheels and it's painted like a rainbow.
I wish I had a pretend bicycle.
You can, and it can be anything you like.
Okay, my pretend bicycle is pink and fluffy.
Wow!
Here is Danny Dog.
Hello.
Hello, Danny.
Do you want to play ball?
Have you got a ball?
No.
It doesn't matter. We can have a pretend ball. Catch, Danny!
Let's give it a big kick. Oof!
Oh! Hello, everyone.
It is Rebecca Rabbit.
Hello, Rebecca. We're playing with a pretend ball.
Until Danny kicked it over there. Oh, I know a pretending game. You have to guess what I am. You're a rabbit. No, I'm pretending to be something else.
Are you a donkey?
No.
Are you a fluffy elephant?
No.
A space rocket?
No. This is going to take a long time, isn't it? Ask me if I'm big. Are you big? No. I'll give you a clue. I'm a vegetable.
Can you give us a better clue?
Ask me if I'm a carrot.
Are you a carrot?
Yes.
Hooray!
Scooter George. Shall I teach you how to scooter? Okay, you hold on to the handlebars like this with both hands. Now stand on the scooter.
Oh.
No, George. Stand on the scooter with one foot. Good. Now push off with the other foot, like this. Whee! Whee! George, you're doing it!
George has learned to scooter.
Peppa, George!
That's enough scootering for now. It's time to go to playgroup.
Oh, we've only just started scootering. Can we ride our scooters to playgroup, Daddy?
Good idea. We could do with the exercise.
Hooray! Ready, steady, go!
Whee! Wait for me! See you later, Mummy Pig!
See you later!
Peppa and George are riding their scooters to playgroup.
Not so fast!
Come on, Daddy!
Daddy can't keep up! Wait for me!
Peppa and George have arrived at playgroup.
Bye. Oh, now I'm going to have to walk back home. What I need are some wheels. Hang on, I've got wheels. Whee! Ha ha! This is fun!
Daddy Pig likes scootering.
Brum, brum. Whee!
Daddy Pig, you're riding Peppa's scooter.
Yes, scootering is such fun.
Wow, you both look the same.
That's because we're identical twins.
Identical twins look like each other.
Do people get you mixed up?
Sometimes, but it's okay. We're used to it.
Piggy, Pandora, as it is your first time at playgroup, you may both choose what we do today.
We like solving mysteries and we like doing puzzles.
Mysteries and puzzles. Let me see. Yes, we have a jigsaw puzzle.
Hooray!
We love jigsaws.
This looks like a cloud. And here is the sun. Maybe they fit together. No, they don't fit.
Try turning that piece around.
Now they fit.
Where does this piece go?
Try putting the blue sky with the blue sky.
It fits.
And the green grass with the green grass.
The jigsaw is finished.
It's a picture of a house on a sunny day.
Well done, children. That was great teamwork. Are you enjoying your day, Pandora, Piggy?
Yes, thank you. We love doing puzzles and solving mysteries. Our daddy is a policeman.
Ooh! I want to be a policeman when I grow up. The police drive cars with flashing lights.
And they go...
Nina, 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 Nina.
Yes, yes. Perhaps now is a good time to phone your daddy and let him know how we're getting on. Oh, where is my phone? I must have put it down somewhere.
Have you lost your phone, Madam Gazelle?
Yes, I had it just now. Where can it be?
Where did you last see it?
If I knew that, Suzy, I wouldn't be looking for it, would I?
Why don't you always put things in the same place, Madam Gazelle? Then you will know where they are.
Well, that is very good advice, Suzy. But it is not always possible to put something down in the same place every time.
We love fireworks!
Hello, Madam Gazelle. Where do you want these fireworks?
Put them on the next hill, please, Mr. Bull.
Okie dokie.
Children, before we celebrate Chinese New Year, we must sweep up.
Why?
We must sweep out the old year before we welcome in the new year.
Finished, Madam Gazelle!
Lovely. Now, we must be careful not to sweep anymore, so please hide all the brushes.
All the children are hiding their brushes.
Madam Gazelle, why do we hide the brushes?
So we don't sweep away the good luck that the new year brings, Pedro.
Okay.
When you have good luck, nice things happen.
Ooh.
Can I have some good luck, please?
And me.
They say if you wear something red, it will bring you good luck.
Peppa and her friends pick something red to wear.
I'm wearing lucky red shoes.
I'm wearing a red hat.
I'm wearing a red scarf.
And my red dress.
Ah, a red scarf and a red dress? That will make you extra lucky, Peppa.
That's not fair. I want to be extra lucky too.
If I am extra lucky, I will share it with you, Suzy.
Thank you, Peppa.
Peppa and Suzy are best friends.
Now, to celebrate the new year, we will have a dragon dance with a big dragon like this.
Ooh!
Is it a scary dragon?
No, Danny. It is a super friendly dragon.
Where is it?
We are going to make it.
What's that?
It looks like a sausage.
It might look like a sausage now, but soon it will be a magnificent dragon.
How do we make the sausage look like a dragon?
With cardboard and paints, ribbons, and your imagination.
Peppa and her friends are making a dragon.
Today we have a visitor.
Ooh!
Mandy Mouse.
Hello, everyone.
Squeak!
Hello!
Mandy Mouse uses a wheelchair to get around.
Mandy is spending the day at our playgroup. If she likes it, she will come every day.
See you later, Mandy. Have fun.
Bye, Mummy.
Hello, Mandy. I'm Peppa Pig.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello, I'm Danny Dog.
And I'm Suzy Sheep.
We're drawing pictures. I drew the sun.
Ooh.
I drew a cloud.
Ooh.
I drew the sky. That's nice. I like drawing aeroplanes.
Wow.
That's a really good drawing.
Thank you.
It is playtime.
That was fun.
Wow, you're fast.
All thanks to my wheelchair.
Why do you have a wheelchair, Mandy?
Because my legs don't work like yours.
Can you walk on your legs?
No, I have my wheels.
Ooh.
See, I get around fine. I can do everything.
Squeak!
Let's play ball.
Yes, please.
Squeak!
Okay, Mandy, you're on my team.
Suzy, you're on my team.
Gerald.
Pedro.
Molly.
And Emily.
The children are in two teams.
How do you play this game?
The captain takes the ball and throws it over there.
No, I know the rules and you're
the
not
one holding the ball.
I say you do it this way.
That is the rules because I said so.
What about the team who gets the ball through the hoop wins?
Okay. Yes, Daddy. Madam Gazelle said I have to practice.
Oh, yes. Practice makes perfect.
Will you help me?
Of course Daddy Pig will help you while I, do some work in another room.
Suzy is practicing too.
Yes, that's it. La, 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 la.
Very good, Danny. Shall we call that a day?
No. Madam Gazelle said I had to keep on trying until I get it right.
Peppa and her friends have been practicing their recorders all week. They are giving a concert for the parents.
Welcome to our concert. Ready, children?
Bravo! Bravo! Ah.
Hard. Yes, it was a very good experience for them.
It's hard to think it was only for a week of our lives, and now it's over.
Children, for our next concert, I want you to learn this tune.
Hooray!
Go home and practice, practice, practice.
Peppa loves the recorder. Everyone loves the recorder.
When we have a picnic, Mrs. Duck always shows up.
Ah, there's no chance of Mrs. Duck showing up in the middle of a desert.
Oh.
It is a duck-billed platypus.
Mrs. Duck-billed platypus always shows up when we have picnics.
Food's ready! Corn on the cob for everyone!
Hooray!
Peppa likes corn on the cob. Everyone likes corn on the cob.
I think it's time for a game.
Sure thing. I've brought a cricket bat.
Oh, do you play cricket in Australia?
Do we play cricket? We're born playing cricket.
Cricket!
How do you play it?
You hit the ball with the bat.
Ah!
If we catch it, you're out. Ready, Dad? You're out, Dad.
Ha-ha! Your go, Peppa.
Good shot, Peppa.
Oh, dear. The ball has landed in the tree.
Oh, it's the only tree for miles, and our ball gets stuck in it.
If I lift you up, Peppa, can you see the ball?
A teddy bear is holding on to it.
That's not a teddy bear, Peppa. That's a koala. Thanks, mate.
That is the sweetest animal I've ever seen. But you are sweet too, Mrs. Duckbill Platypus. Yes, you are.
Okay, everybody, it's home time.
You're staying at our house tonight, Peppa.
Yippee! I loved our picnic in the outback. Can we do it again tomorrow?
There are loads of other great things we can do while you're here, Peppa.
Oh, goody. Night-night.
Night-night.
Peppa and George are asleep after their first day on holiday with Kylie Kangaroo. George wants to go surfing.
Sorry, George, you're a bit too little to go surfing.
Oh, the waves are getting too big for Peppa and Kylie.
Oh, is it time to go home?
Are you kidding? These waves are perfect for grown-ups to surf.
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Wow!
Kylie, where's your little brother?
He's out there with Mum.
Having fun, Joey?
Your turn to surf, guys. Thank you, but I'm quite happy to watch.
Why don't you have a go, Mr. Pig?
Why not? It does look fun.
Aw, the waves have gone.
Too bad, Mr. Pig. Looks like you've missed your chance to surf today.
Oh, that's a shame.
But it's just right for little George to go paddling in.
I'll come with you, George. No surfing, George, but you can sit on me instead.
George likes sitting on top of Daddy Pig.
Look at that wave coming!
Crikey, it's a big one.
Daddy, there's a big wave coming!
Wave! What's that?
Wave!
I think they want us to wave, George. Cooey! Cooey!
George is using Daddy Pig as a surfboard.
Wow, George has got great balance.
Hooray!
You're a natural surfer, George. Maybe you can teach me a few tricks.
George is the best.
But how can you work in the sea?
With this submarine.
Wow!
Do you want a ride?
Yes, please!
Okay, hop in!
Wow! It's all the colours of the rainbow!
That's coral. Coral is made of lots and lots of tiny creatures.
Ooh!
And the coral stretches for miles and miles.
We call it the Great Barrier Reef.
It's my job to keep the coral safe.
Can we take some coral home with us?
Sorry, Peppa. We can look, but we mustn't touch.
If every visitor took a little bit of coral home,
soon all the coral would be gone.
We must never, never take anything away from here.
Ah! Look! Little fish.
They're clownfish.
Clownfish? They do look quite funny.
Look over there!
A big blue starfish!
There's a tiny red one!
And a spiky green one!
What's that?
That's a turtle!
Ooh! Hello, Mrs. Turtle! How are you today?
You see how lucky I am to work in such an amazing place, Peppa?
Look! A little bridge, just like in your fish tank.
Oh, you're right, Peppa. It is quite like the fish tank here, except there's no treasure chest, of course.
What have you seen, George?
It looks like a chest full of gold coins.
Wow!
George has found a treasure chest.
You see, Daddy, everything is the same as the fish tank.
Always look where you're going. Then... Whoosh!
Dr. Brown Bear is rolling down the hill.
Ow! 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 Ow!
He rolled through a prickly bush.
Ow! Ow!
Oof. He hit a tree.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
And apples fell on his head.
Oh!
Oh, my goodness! Call an ambulance!
The ambulance is here!
Oh, yes! Everyone into the ambulance! Don't worry, Dr. Brown Bear. We are here to make you better.
Thank you, but I don't think I need your help. I am the doctor, remember?
Yes, but we must do all the checks.
I really don't think this is...
Not another word. Children, what do we do first?
Check he's awake.
Well done, Peppa.
Are you awake, doctor?
Yes.
Good. He is awake.
This is all very nice of you, but
I... Who knows what to do next?
We ask him his name.
Yes, but in this case it's
what
not...
What is your name?
Dr. Brown Bear.
Now we ask him what happened.
You saw what happened. I tripped over that ball and fell down the hill.
That was a bit silly now, wasn't it? Which bit is hurting?
Every bit is hurting.
Where is it hurting most?
In my arm, and my leg, and here on my head.
We just need to bandage him up.
Because you have been such a brave doctor, you get a sticker.
Oh!
Have a sticker! Have a sticker!
Children, say thank you to Dr. Brown Bear for giving us such a wonderful demonstration of how the ambulance works.
Thank you, Dr. Brown Bear.
It was my pleasure.
Dr. Brown Bear loves ambulances. Everybody loves ambulances.
Don't worry, I am Super Pedro. Ow!
Oh, dear. What has happened?
Tiddles fell on Pedro's nose.
My nose hurts.
Poor Pedro. I will call for the doctor.
Dr. Brown Bear speaking. A bumped nose, you say? I'll be right there. Hello. Where is the patient?
Here. My nose hurts.
I see. Say ah.
Ah.
You need a plaster. There. That will make it better.
Hooray!
My glasses don't work.
Pedro's glasses are all muddy.
Oh, Dr. Brown Bear, can you fix Pedro's glasses?
No, I can't. You'll need an optician for that.
An optician is a doctor who knows about glasses.
My daddy's an optician.
Hello, Dr. Pony speaking. A pair of glasses not working, you say? I'm on my way.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, son. What seems to be the problem?
My glasses aren't working.
Can you read this chart?
No, my glasses aren't working.
Why, these glasses just need a good clean. Is that better?
Yes. Thank you, Daddy.
Dr. Pony has fixed Pedro's glasses.
Hooray!
Thank you, doctors. Everything is back to normal.
But Tiddles needs helping too.
Hmm, its legs are wiggling in the air.
It seems to be upside down.
Can you doctors help a tortoise in trouble?
No, I'm afraid we can't treat animals.
Oh.
You need a vet.
A vet is a doctor for animals.
Doctors now recommend you eat 7 a day.
Always remember to eat your 7.
Right. Let's all give Super Potato a nice big clap for coming to see us today.
Thank you. Thank you. And remember, kids, eat fruit and vegetables.
Super Potato has left the building.
Oh, dear. Did I miss him?
Yes!
He was brilliant.
Well, it was lovely to see you all, but I'd better be going too. Bye.
Come on, children. Let's wave Mr. Potato goodbye.
Oh, dear. Mr. Potato's car won't start.
Ah! I cannot get out!
Mr. Potato is stuck.
Help! Let me out!
What shall we do?
Help!
Call for Super Potato!
Let me out!
Super Potato! Super Potato!
I think he might be too busy to come.
No, really, really, I do not think that will work this time.
No, Madam Gazelle, you just need to shout out with us.
Okay. Help us, Super Potato! There, it didn't work. Now I think we
need... What's that in the sky?
Is it a bird?
Is it a plane?
No, it's a potato!
By the power of vegetables, I am here!
Hooray!
Super Potato has come to the rescue.
Using my super vegetable vision, I can see that my friend here is in trouble.
Yes, you have to get him out.
I will use my fruity strength to lift this roof off. Hoo-ha!
Super Potato has rescued Mr. Potato.
Hooray!
And remember, kids, when trouble calls...
Eat your fruit and vegetables!
Fruit and vegetables keep us alive. Always remember to eat your 5. 7. Always remember to eat your 7.
Hello, Grandpa Pig.
Hello.
Hello, old bean.
Grandpa, that man just called you an old bean.
Yes, Peppa. It's another way of saying old friend.
Are they your friends, Grandpa?
Oh, not really. We're just members of the same sailing club. Now, where did I leave my boat?
What does your boat look like, Grandpa?
It has a little red flag on top of the mast.
Like that little flag?
Ah, yes.
Oh, dear. Grandpa Pig's sailing boat has sunk.
I'm afraid we can't go sailing today, children.
Oh.
Here is Grampy Rabbit on his hovercraft.
What is that monstrosity?
Is it allowed at the sailing club?
Hello! What a marvelous day for sailing!
Hello, Grampy Rabbit.
Peppa, you look sad. What's the matter?
We can't go sailing because our boat has sunk.
Oh, dear. Why don't you hop onto my hovercraft?
Hooray!
I really don't think this is quite...
Hold on to your hats!
Grampy Rabbit's hovercraft can go on land and water.
I built it myself! You'd never guess, would you? We don't need that bit.
You can't drive this thing around here. You're not a member of the sailing club.
Well, you're a member, aren't you?
Yes, but...
That's all right, then.
Nothing like a peaceful day's sailing.
The calmness of the water, the quietness of the... Oh, what's that horrible noise?
Hello there! Lovely day for a sail!
It's that monstrosity again!
Is that Grandpa Pig?
Hello?
Are you still sad because you never got to play Group Star, Daddy?
You know what, Peppa? The more I think about it, the more I think I should have got a playgroup star.
Why?
Because I love to make things, and I was always drawing in class.
What was your best drawing, Daddy?
Would you like to see it? I think I've still got it somewhere. I'm sure I put it in the loft. Ah, here's my old school bag. And here is my picture.
Wow, it's a dragon.
Grrr.
It's very good, Daddy.
Yes, I was quite pleased with it.
But it didn't get a star.
Nope.
That's sad.
It is the next day. Peppa and George are going to playgroup.
Look at this, Suzy.
It's not fair, Peppa. You're too good at drawing.
It's not my drawing. It's my daddy's.
Oh, not so good for a grown-up.
He drew it a long time ago when he was little.
Ah. Peppa, have you done another wonderful drawing?
No, Madam Gazelle. This is my daddy's drawing.
Ah, yes. I remember your daddy did like to draw.
But you never gave him a playgroup star.
I must have given him one for this.
No, you didn't.
Daddy Pig, you deserve a playgroup star.
Oh, I've never been so proud.
Daddy Pig is a playgroup star.
Hooray for Daddy Pig!
The picnic basket!
It's very good of you to steer the boat, Grampy Rabbit.
But I'm not steering the boat. I thought somebody else was.
Oh, dear. No one is steering the boat.
We're lost at sea!
And look! Grampy Rabbit's boat is sinking!
Don't panic! I've been in worse situations than this!
Really?
No. This is the worst. We're saved!
But we're stuck on a desert island!
With just the sea and the sky for company.
And we haven't got any food.
Ooh, I've got a chocolate bar.
Good. We should save the chocolate in case we get hungry later.
Oh dear. Grampy Rabbit has eaten all the food.
What a terrible place to be stuck. Is anyone else missing cheese?
We've only been here 5 minutes, Grampy Rabbit.
I'm going to put a mark in the sand for every time I think about cheese.
We need to call for help.
Call for help? What an excellent idea!
Grampy Rabbit is very good at shouting.
Help!
What was that?
That was the call of the sea. Someone is in trouble.
What can we do?
We'll rescue them. We can use Granddad Dog's boat. Wait a minute. I said I'd never get on a boat again.
But, Daddy, they need rescuing.
You're right. Just this once, I shall sail again. Life jackets on.
Aye, Captain Dog.
Full sail!
All our food is gone. There's nothing left to eat.
There must be something to eat.
Who wants to be in my perfume? I'm going to put you in my beaker of water.
Hello, butterfly. I'm making perfume. It's going to be the prettiest, smelliest perfume ever. Lovely!
Here is George.
Stand back, George. I'm making perfume. Do you want to watch? First, I pick a smelly flower. Very flowery. Then I put it in my beaker. No, George. You can't put grass in my perfume. It needs the smell of flowers. Smell!
Yuck!
George does not like smelly flowers. Grandpa Pig is in his herb garden.
Grandpa! Grandpa! Smell this!
Pooey! It smells like pond water.
It's my special perfume. I made it with flowers from the garden.
Oh, yes. It's the most beautiful perfume in the world.
Yes.
Do you like it, George?
No.
George doesn't like the smell of flowers.
Take this bucket, George. You can make perfume out of something else. I have got lots of lovely smelly things in my herb garden. This is rosemary. I like to use it in my cooking.
It smells interesting.
This is mint.
Oh, that smells very minty.
And this is lavender.
Oh, that smells like Granny Pig's perfume.
Wow, that's a strong smell of lavender.
Can I be a mountain leopard, please?
No. I can only do fruit.
OK. Can I be...
a plum! There.
Peppa is in charge of the lucky dip.
Roll up! Roll up! For your lucky dip!
Moo! Hello, Peppa!
Hello, Mr. Bull. You've got a green face.
I'm an apple.
Ooh. Would you like to try the lucky dip?
OK. What do I do?
Just pull a prize out of the barrel. Everyone a winner.
Mr. Bull has won a dolly.
Can I have a go?
Mrs. Cat has won a digger.
Oh, do you want to swap?
No, thank you.
Mr. Bull and Mrs. Cat like their lucky dip prizes.
Roll up, roll up.
Freddy Fox is in charge of the mummies and daddies race.
Thank you. It's all to raise money for a new school roof.
I'm quite good at running.
It's not running, Daddy. It's a sack race.
Oh.
You have to get in the bag and jump over there. As fast as you can.
Right.
On your marks, get set, go! And they've fallen down.
Oh.
That was fun, wasn't it?
Yes, lots of fun.
But really, we must thank the children for all their hard work.
Thank you, children.
And we have raised enough money to buy a new school roof. Again.
Hooray!
Broom has a tank full of little fish.
Fishy!
Wow! There are millions of teeny fish.
Fishy, fishy, fish, fish, swimming in the sea. Who will be a fishy friend for my fish, Goldie?
Could any of these be Goldie's friend?
No, they are too small.
Let's see what fish are in the next room.
Okay.
Here is Candy Cat and her family.
Hello, Candy.
Hello, Peppa.
Meow.
What are you doing here?
We come here all the time.
It's better than watching TV.
We like fish.
We've come to find a friend for Goldie the fish.
Oh, what's in this tank?
I can't see anything.
Oh, Daddy Pig, there's a fish right in front of you.
Where? Whoa!
It is a very big fish.
Wow!
Do you think this fish could be a friend for Goldie?
No, it is too big.
Never mind. Let's go to the next room.
What's in this tank?
Dinosaur.
George thinks he has seen a dinosaur.
It's not a dinosaur, George. It's a funny kind of fish called a seahorse.
You know lots about fish.
Yes, I like fish.
Can the seahorse be Goldie's friend?
No. It's too dinosaur-y.
One more room to go.
Oh, what's in this tank?
Nothing. It's just green slime. Look.
That green slime is algae.
There must be some sort of fish in here. Whoa! There's a fish with big, long ears. It's a rabbit fish.
It is Miss Rabbit, wearing a diving costume.
Ooh.
She is cleaning the fish tank. Miss Rabbit is saying hello. It is difficult to talk underwater. Here are Danny Dog, Zoe Zebra and Pedro Pony.
Hello, everyone. Look at George's racing car.
Wow! I'll race you.
And me.
And me.
I want to race too. Where's your racing car, Peppa? I don't have a racing car.
Don't worry, Peppa. You can be the chief mechanic.
What does that do?
You fix George's car if it goes wrong.
Oh, goody. I hope it goes wrong a lot.
Let's start the race.
Three times round the garden.
Ready? Steady? Go!
Meow. And they're off.
Come on, George!
That's the end of lap one and George is in the lead.
What's all this noise out here? I'm trying to watch television.
We're having a race, Granny.
That's the end of lap two, and George is still in the lead. Oh, dear, a wheel has come off George's car.
Where's the chief mechanic?
Here I am.
What do we do?
Put the wheel back on.
Okay, chief mechanic.
Oh, dear. George is now at the back of the race.
Pedal faster, George!
Come on, George!
Come on, George!
George is the winner!
Hooray!
Well done, George! You're the best racing driver in the whole world!
It's got wheels.
Car.
It's not a car, George. It's got legs. It's a table.
It's got a tail.
Oh, tables don't have tails.
There's a handle as well.
What can it be?
There's something else in the box. It's a toy horse. I shall call it Twinkle Toes.
Horsey, Twinkle Toes. Horsey, Twinkle Toes.
Horsey.
Remember, children, Aunt Dottie sent the present for both of you.
You'll have to share. Sharing can be fun.
Can I play with Twinkle Toes first?
Let George have the first turn. He's the youngest.
Horsey! Horsey!
George likes playing with Horsey.
George, it is called Twinkle Toes, not Horsey.
Now it's Peppa's turn.
I am Princess Peppa with my magic horse, Twinkle Toes.
Peppa likes playing with Twinkle Toes.
Whoops!
Perhaps you should play with the toy horse outside.
Yes, Mummy.
It's a bit steep here. Maybe you should play at the bottom of the hill. And the quickest way down the hill is to ride down.
Are you sure, Daddy? Don't crash like you always do.
Ho, ho! I know what I'm doing, Peppa. I'm a grown-up.
Yee-haw!
How are you going to stop, Daddy?
I don't know. Where are the brakes?
Clever, Daddy. You use the duck pond to stop.
What was that big splash?
What big splash?
Daddy Pig, did you know you've got a duck on your head?
Oh, yes. Well, I did fall in the pond.
Granny and Grandpa like antiques.
What does antique mean?
Antique means old and rare.
Usually, yes. But my antiques are brand new. That chair comes in a set of 12. Nice, isn't it?
Is it made of oak?
Yes, it's made of plastic oak.
Is it comfortable?
You mustn't sit on it. Antique chairs are not for sitting on.
So, what do you do with them?
You look at them.
That's not much fun, even for a grown-up.
Buying a present for Granny and Grandpa is hard work.
I don't understand. My shop sells everything. There must be something you like.
There is. I like this teddy. And I think Granny and Grandpa would like it too.
Oh, oh, let's buy the teddy then.
A very good choice. Who's going to pay? 1 penny and 2 buttons. Here's your change. 1 button.
Thank you, Mr. Fox.
Peppa and her family have come to give Granny and Grandpa Pig their presents.
Granny Pig! Grandpa Pig!
Hello, my little ones.
Happy anniversary.
Oh, another glass vase.
It's a grown-up present. That's why it's a bit boring.
It's lovely. We'll put it with our other glass vases.
George and me bought you a present too. I hope you like it.
A teddy bear for Grandpa and me.
Thank you, Peppa and George.
He's very good at cuddling.
Does he have a name?
He's called Eddie the Teddy.
And what does Eddie like to eat?
Chocolate and broccoli.
That's the best present we've ever had.
Oh, but if Eddie is going to live here, he'll need children to play with.
We can play with him, Granny.
And every time you visit us, he'll be here for you to play with.
Oh, goody.
Tiddles.
Tiddles is climbing higher in the tree.
Come here, you little pickle.
Mummy Cow is climbing into the tree.
Be careful, Mummy Cow.
Oh, dear. I'm stuck.
Cows are not very good at climbing trees.
Hang on. I'm coming up. Here, Tiddles. Oh, I'm stuck too.
Elephants are not very good at climbing trees.
Well, didn't work, did it?
What What are we going to do now?
Chop the tree down!
No!
I'll call the next rescue service.
Hello! Granddad Dog's Breakdown Service.
Hello. Tiddles the tortoise is up a tree.
Tortoise up a tree? Again? I'll be right there. Hmm. How do you get tortoises out of trees?
Chop the tree down!
Yes, let's chop the tree down.
No!
OK, I'll climb up instead.
Hooray!
Oh, I seem to be stuck.
Dogs are not very good at climbing trees.
Now can we chop the tree down?
No. We'll have to call the highest rescue service in the land.
OK, I'm on my way.
It is Miss Rabbit in her rescue helicopter.
Hello, everyone. Let's rescue this tortoise.
Who's flying your helicopter?
Oops, silly me. I'll just put the autopilot on.
Autopilot on. Have a nice day.
Autopilots fly helicopters on their own.
Got you, you little rascal.
Miss Rabbit has rescued Tiddles.
Hooray!
Peppa and Susie are getting Goldie the fish ready.
Eat up, Goldie. You've got a big day tomorrow.
I will polish your bowl.
Lovely.
Pedro is talking to his stick insect. A stick insect is an insect that looks like a stick.
Tomorrow, you will come with me to playgroup. They will decide who is the best pet. And it will be you.
Edmund Elephant is talking to his gecko.
Watch me. Now you do it.
Zoe Zebra is talking to her monkey.
Are you excited about the competition, monkey? Remember to be good tomorrow. Don't be a cheeky monkey.
It is the day of the pet competition.
Madam Gazelle, who is going to decide which pet is the best?
Dr. Hamster.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Oh, what lovely pets you've got. That's a happy little fish. What's its name?
It's Goldie. You've met her before.
She's got a very shiny bowl.
What does Goldie like doing?
She likes swimming around and going like this.
Wonderful. And who is this?
This is my stick insect.
What's his name?
Stephen.
What does he do?
He looks like a stick.
Amazing. Oh, what kind of animal is this?
It is a gecko.
Does he have a name?
Hemidactylus frenatus.
Edmund Elephant is a clever clogs.
Right. And what does he do?
This.
Oh, who's next?
Ooh, monkey.
Is he meant to be upside down?
Yes, he's asleep.
Oh, I see. Well, he's lovely. I've brought my pet too. Tiddles the tortoise.
Hello, Mr. Skinny Legs. Oh, where have you gone?
Find it. I don't want it in the house.
Everyone is looking for Mr. Skinny Legs. Mr. Skinny Legs is not in the filing cabinet. Mr. Skinny Legs is not under the chair. Mr. Skinny Legs is not on the table.
Oh, I wonder where Mr. Skinny Legs is. It sounds like Mummy has found him.
Don't be scared, Mummy.
Get rid of it.
OK, we'll take Mr. Skinny Legs into the garden. Now Mr. Skinny Legs has got the whole garden to play in.
Bye-bye, Mr. Skinny Legs.
It is starting to rain. Mr. Skinny Legs is running back to the house.
Maybe he doesn't like the rain.
He's climbing up the water spout.
Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed poor Incy out. Out came the sunshine and dried up all the rain. Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the spout again.
I don't want Mr. Skinny Legs in the house, Daddy Pig.
Let's take Mr. Skinny Legs a bit further into the garden. There we are. A nice tree for you to live in.
What is he doing?
He's making a web, Peppa. Spiders live in webs and use them to catch flies.
Oh! He's very busy.
Yes. It's hard work building a web. That's why you must never, ever break one. If you do, the spider has to do all the work again.
Yes, Daddy. Bye-bye, Mr. Skinny Legs.
You pick a marble and you put it in here. And it goes timble-tumble all the way down to the bottom.
Ooh!
I'll show you. Ready, steady, go!
again!
Bye-bye, Mummy. You can go and do your work now.
Oh, thank you, Peppa. Have fun.
Can I have a go?
Yes, Rebecca. You take this marble and you...
Ready, steady, go! That was fun.
And then you can add some more bits to the marble run. Let's make it the biggest marble run ever.
Yay! Let's add this wiggly bit.
And a windmill bit. The marble will make it go round and round. Do you want to have a go, George? Ready, steady, go! It's going down the windmill bit.
And the wiggly bit.
And there.
Hooray! Let's add more bits.
Yes, let's make the biggest marble run ever. Wow! That looks good, Rebecca.
Now it's Richard's turn.
Marble run!
Richard has lots of marbles.
Ready, steady,
go!
Look at all the marbles going everywhere!
I thought I heard your marble run, Peppa. Can I join in?
Yes, Daddy.
Oh, goody. Let's make it bigger.
Daddy Pig loves building the marble run.
Ah, there are no more bits of marble run left in the box.
Oh.
Never mind. We can use other things.
I sell you this morning. I've a solar-powered torch, a wooden frying pan, an electric gnome.
Nothing for us today, thank you, Mr. Fox.
Unless you've got a metal detector.
Metal detector? Well, why didn't you say so? I've got a metal detector right here.
Fantastic. It's just like my old one.
It's got three settings: finding things, good at finding things, and really good at finding things.
Excellent. We'll take it.
Now we can find George's lost key.
Hooray!
How does the metal detector work, Grandpa?
I'll show you. Imagine I have lost this coin. I turn on the metal detector and swing it gently from side to side. I'm looking for it here. I'm looking for it there.
But, Grandpa, you put the coin here.
I know, Peppa. I'm just pretending to look for it.
Why don't you pretend to look for it here?
Here, you say? Aha! I've found something. It's a coin.
Yes, Grandpa. It's the one you just put there.
Yes, Peppa. And that's how you find things, with a metal detector.
Can we have a go?
Of course. Let's find that lost key.
Here.
There. Here. We found something.
No, it's a nail.
Oh.
Keep looking.
Here. There. There's something else.
A spoon. What's that doing here?
This is fun. Key, key.
George wants to find the key.
Ooh, what is it, Grandpa?
It's the key.
Hooray!
Now we can wind up Mr. Robot.
No.
George never wants to lose the key again.
Don't worry, George. If the key falls out again, we can find it with my new metal detector.
It's World Book Day tomorrow, and we have to dress up as someone from a book.
That sounds exciting. Who are you going to be, Peppa?
You've got lots of books to choose from.
Yes! I can go as a sleepy princess from this book.
Yes, I love reading you this story. Once upon a time, there lived a...
Or maybe I can go as the red monkey.
I love that book too.
I can't decide. All the books are good.
Why not go as Funny Onion from the book that Mummy Pig wrote?
No, Daddy. It has to be a real book, not Mummy's book.
Thank you very much, Peppa.
Once upon a time, there was an onion called Funny Onion. 4, 7, 6, 8, 5, 9, 3, 1, 2.
Most of Mummy Pig's book is one big long number.
Yes, there were a few printing problems. How about this book?
The Tiny Magic Fairy.
Yes!
I'm a tiny magic fairy.
And George, what's your favourite book?
Dinosaur.
Of course, your pop-up dinosaur book.
Well, that's settled. George will go to World Book Day as a dinosaur and Peppa will go as a tiny fairy.
Or maybe a duck.
Quack, quack.
It is nearly bedtime.
Aha!
I'm the happy pirate from the pirate book. Pirates are my favourite because they are funny and they sing happy songs and...
Brush their teeth?
Yes, brush their teeth.
Are we all ready for World Book Day tomorrow?
No. My favourite book keeps changing.
Don't worry, Peppa. You can decide in the morning.
This is the Children's Festival.
Wow! Welcome to the festival!
At the Children's Festival, there are so many fun things to see and do. Here is Suzy Sheep.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello, Suzy.
Isn't this great?
It's brilliant.
There's so much going on. What shall we do first?
We've got making things, sandcastles, storytelling.
Yes, I like stories.
Me too.
This is the story tent. All of Peppa's friends are here.
Hello, children. If you want a story about a pirate, say, aha! Good. Once upon a time, there was a pirate. He found a desert island and he dug up some buried treasure. The end.
What an adventure! That story makes me miss the sea. I must set sail at once and find that desert island.
Captain Dog loves the sea.
It's just a story, Daddy. You don't need to set sail.
Oh, yes. No need for me to set sail ever again.
I like the children's festival.
Yes, and not a drop of rain. We've been really lucky this year.
I told you it wouldn't be muddy.
A little bit of mud would be nice.
This way to the making things tent.
Today, we're going to learn how to make something from the olden days. Who wants to make a basket? Okie dokie. How about knitting an olden days hat? How about a dragon?
All the children are making dragons.
What's it like out there, Daddy Pig? Is there any mud?
A little bit of mud, yes.
Oh, my goodness!
Wow! So much mud!
Yes, well, it does say it can get a tiny bit muddy here sometimes.
A tiny bit muddy? I've never seen so much mud in all my life.
It's brilliant!
Yes, and we've got a whole day at the festival ahead of us.
At the Children's Festival, there are so many fun things to see and do.
Let's start with making sandcastles.
Yippee! Sandcastles!
This is the sandcastle area.
Who likes making sandcastles?
Yay!
Now, you might have noticed it's been raining. So instead of sandcastles, we're making mud castles.
Hooray!
First, fill your buckets with mud. Turn your buckets over. Give them a tap. Lift your buckets. Mud castles.
I like mud castles.
Mud castles are the best.
Well done, Miss Rabbit. How did you ever come up with the idea for mud castles?
Simple. It rains every year, so we always make mud castles.
Ah. So what do we want to do next?
How about painting pictures?
Yay!
This is the painting tent.
Today, we're going to paint pictures. And instead of paint, we're using mud.
Ooh!
We've got lots of brown mud and greenish mud. I even found some blue mud this morning.
What's best to paint with mud? I know! A muddy puddle!
The children are painting mud pictures.
Miss Rabbit, please come to our rescue.
It's very important. Come quickly.
I'm on my way.
All the children have brought their pumpkin lanterns to playgroup.
Welcome to the pumpkin competition. If everyone is here, we will get started.
Peppa isn't here.
Oh, where is she?
Miss Rabbit's rescue helicopter has arrived at Grandpa's greenhouse.
So, who needs rescuing?
My pumpkin!
We have to get it to the playgroup in time for the competition.
Okay. Hop aboard! Next stop, the playgroup.
I think we will have to start without Peppa.
Aw, it won't be fun without Peppa.
The prize for the best pumpkin grown from seed goes to Suzy Sheep.
That's me.
This is fun.
The prize for the best pumpkin bought from a supermarket goes to Pedro Pony.
That's me.
Nay.
The prize for the best plastic pumpkin goes to...
What's that noise?
Look!
What's that?
There's a light in the sky.
Ooh.
It's a flying pumpkin.
It's Peppa's pumpkin.
Wow!
Hello! Sorry we're late.
Hello, Peppa!
Am I in time for the pumpkin competition?
Yes, of course! The prize for the best flying pumpkin goes to... Peppa Pig.
Hooray!
This is the best Halloween ever!
Peppa loves Halloween. Everyone loves Halloween.
Marching along, beating your drums. That's it! Marvelous marching, children. Wasn't that fun?
Yes, Majesty!
The next piece of music is a little bit different. Remember, I want you to listen to it carefully and think about how it makes you feel.
This music is about space.
It's an alien birthday party.
Oh, what is wrong with this machine?
Robots from the future.
Hello, I'm an alien. Bleep, bleep, bloop, bloop. I am a robot.
again. There.
Oh.
Now tell me, how does this make you feel?
It makes me feel a bit bored.
It makes me feel tired.
Has the music machine gone wrong again?
No, this is music. It reminds me of a lovely garden on a hot summer day. A young man, a broken heart.
Please, can we have the space music again?
That was not music, it was the machine gone wrong. Do you not like this music?
No.
Madam Gazelle, can you make the machine go wrong again?
No.
Oh!
I suppose we cannot all like the same things in life.
I like the space music.
And me.
And me.
Okay. What does this music make you think of?
I know. This music makes me think of jumping up and down in muddy puddles. This way! Follow me, everyone! Jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
Splish, splash, splosh, splish, splash.
If it rang six times, would that make it 6 o'clock?
Yes, it would.
And if it rang 100 times?
Then it would be broken. On with the tour. Next stop, Tower Bridge. We need to cross the bridge to continue the tour.
Stop! You can't cross!
Look, there's a big ship. It's going to bang into the bridge. The bridge is lifting up.
Wow!
Tower Bridge lifts to let tall ships sail through.
Good. Now the ship has passed, we can be on our way. Please lower the bridge.
I'm sorry, Your Majesty, but there's another ship coming.
This is really too much. We can't wait around all day. Hold tight, everyone.
Is balancing on the bridge.
Now what do we do?
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great idea.
Everybody move to the front of the bus.
OK! Hooray!
The Queen is good at driving buses.
Are you enjoying your tour, children?
Yes!
Open-top buses are the best. Why aren't all buses open like this one?
It is raining.
Ah, yes. That's why all buses aren't open like this one.
Children, open your umbrellas.
It is very important to take an umbrella when you visit London.
Let's stop Trafalgar Square. Oh dear, what a shame. Trafalgar Square is full of puddles.
But we love puddles.
Come on, have a seat. Splash, Your Majesty.
It does look rather fun. And one is wearing one's boots.
Whee! The Queen loves jumping in London puddles. Everybody loves jumping in London puddles.
Jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
And what do we need to make a muddy puddle?
Dirt and water.
Dirt and water. Mix them together to make a muddy puddle. Peppa, please test the puddle.
This puddle is too dry.
Let's add some more water. Please jump again, Peppa.
This puddle is just right. Nice and muddy.
And making muddy puddles is a bit like making concrete. Concrete is what we're using to make your new playground. It starts off wet and soft like mud, then it sets and goes hard forever.
Ooh.
Right now, it is gloopy like custard. Let me show you. You see? It's very soft. But who can tell me what's going to happen next?
The concrete will go hard.
Exactly. It will set as hard as rock.
Daddy Pig, I think you should step out of there before...
I'll be with you in a moment, Mr. Bull. I'm just talking to the children.
Yes, but...
You see, the concrete is soft. Still soft. And now... hard.
Wow!
All thanks to a bit of simple science. Now, Mr. Bull, what was it you were saying?
I was trying to say you should get out before the concrete goes hard.
Ah.
Daddy Pig is stuck.
Don't worry, Daddy Pig. I'll have you out in a jiffy.
How?
I'll dig up a playground.
Daddy Pig loves being dug out of concrete. Everyone loves being dug out of concrete.
Dinosaur.
Okay, George, let's get a dinosaur. This way, George. No, no, that way. Back, forward, down. Hooray! We've got the dinosaur.
Oh. The dinosaur toy is too heavy for the grabber.
Oh, try again.
The Mr. Potato Doll is just the right weight for the grabber.
Aren't you lucky? And he's yours to keep. But the best news is you have earned your digger badges. You are fully qualified digger drivers.
Hooray!
Thank you for visiting Digger World, where all your digger dreams come true. Bye.
Bye-bye. I really like Digger World because we get to drive...
Stop!
It is Mr. Bull.
What's the matter, Mr. Bull?
We're building a wall across the road.
Digger, digger. Mr. Bull, can we drive your digger?
Oh, I'm afraid children can't drive diggers.
But we've been to Digger World. We've got badges.
Oh, that's okay then. Hop aboard. I'll drive the digger and you can have the important job of pushing the buttons. Okay now, push the button.
What? This red one?
No, the green one!
The digger has knocked over the new wall.
Sorry, Mr. Bull.
Building things up, then knocking them down. It's all part of the fun with diggers.
Peppa and George love diggers. Everyone loves diggers.
What do you mean?
Look, this elephant is a bit sad, but he just needs more stuffing.
Teddy likes being floppy. Thank you, Miss Rabbit.
Would Mr. Dinosaur like some extra stuff? Okay. Would Teddy like a new outfit? Here we have a smart sailor's uniform.
But Teddy is a girl.
Girls can be sailors too, Peppa.
Yes, but Teddy doesn't want to be a sailor.
How about a pilot?
No.
Deep-sea diver?
No.
What about a princess?
I think Teddy is happy not to have any clothes, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
What about Mr. Dinosaur?
No.
Fair enough. Would Teddy like new eyes? You know what they say, the eyes are the windows to the soul.
What's a soul?
It's a bit complicated. Just look at these eyes. We've got green eyes, blue eyes, or even these googly eyes.
The soul thingy might look a bit wrong with those eyes on. Teddy's eyes don't need changing, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
What about Mr. Dinosaur? Does he want some new eyes?
No.
Fine. One thing I can offer you, Teddy, is a new voice. The voices come in little plastic boxes which go inside the doll.
Hello, I love you.
That isn't how Teddy talks.
I'm so happy. I want to play.
That's not Teddy.
You are my best friend.
But that's Penguin's voice.
You are my best friend.
Susie.
Mr. Dinosaur, do you want a new voice? Silly question, really. There is one last thing I can do for you, Teddy. That's give you a wash.
No, Teddy doesn't need a wash.
Okay, I'm finished. And it's good news. There's nothing wrong with Teddy or Mr. Dinosaur.
That's wonderful.
Would you like to pay by cash or credit card?
Oh.
Teddy, I love you just the way you are, and I always will.
You have to huff.
Huff.
And you have to puff.
Puff.
And blow.
So many bubbles. Pretty bubbles in the sky.
Ooh.
Look at that big bubble.
That's not a bubble, Pedro. That's the full moon.
Ah.
And you know what you do when you see a full moon? You howl.
Ahoo!
Why do you do that?
That's what wolves do.
We howl at the moon.
Wendy, can you teach us how to do that?
Okay. First, you have to look up at the moon. And then you howl.
Ahoo!
Wendy Wolf has taught everyone how to howl like a wolf.
Wow, who did that one?
It wasn't me.
It wasn't me.
It wasn't any of us.
It's a wild animal.
It is Granny Wolf.
Happy birthday, Wendy.
Hello, Granny.
You must all be Wendy's friends. How do you do?
Hello, Granny Wolf.
My, what big ears you've got, Granny Wolf.
All the better to hear you with.
What big eyes you've got, Granny Wolf.
All the better to see you with.
And what big teeth you've got.
All the better to eat birthday cake.
Wendy, what's that in the middle of your cake? It is a little house made of sticks.
Ah!
Time to blow out the candles, Wendy.
I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow the candles out. You've blown the stick house down.
Oh, well done.
That's my goal.
It's like the path in Little Red Riding Hood.
I wouldn't be surprised if we bumped into the big bad wolf.
Hello there.
It is Mr. Wolf.
Hello, Mr. Wolf. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Just a little bit hungry. I'm trying to decide where to go for lunch.
I'm going to my granny's house for lunch.
Are you really?
Yes.
Is it far?
Not far. This is the shortcut. We'll be there soon.
Very good. Oh, well, catch you later.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. That was just like Little Red Riding Hood. Meeting Mr. Wolf in the middle of the woods when I'm going to Granny's house.
Which way now, Daddy Pig?
I'm not sure.
There's a little house over there. Let's ask them the way.
Hello?
Is there anybody home? I wonder who lives here in the middle of the woods.
There are three chairs.
And three bowls of porridge.
Hello, Peppa.
Here are Belinda Bear and Mummy and Daddy Bear.
Hello there.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Bear. Sorry to trouble you.
The door was open, so we came inside.
It's quite all right. It's lovely to see you.
Are you going to stay for lunch, Peppa? It's porridge. It's not too hot or too cold,
but just right.
We're actually on our way to have lunch at Granny and Grandpa Pig's house.
Could you point us in the right direction, please?
That path there will take you to Granny Pig's house.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Wow. That was just like Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Yes, with a little house and three chairs.
And three bowls of porridge.
We are in a fairy tale.
Peppa has arrived at Granny and Grandpa Pig's house.
Granny Pig, we're here.
Hello.
Oh.
Here is Mr. Wolf.
Mr. Wolf, why are you here?
I'm just round for something to eat. Your granny has made a lovely lunch.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
That is how the police say hello.
And how may we help you today?
Dinosaur.
George has lost Mr. Dinosaur.
Don't worry, George. I'm sure you'll find your dinosaur.
All you've got to do is keep your ears and eyes open.
Actually, we were hoping some kind person might have found George's toy dinosaur and brought it here.
I see. We'll need to question George. It's just routine.
Please describe your dinosaur in your own words.
Take your time.
Use as many words as you like.
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur. Excellent description.
Hmm, we do have some lost dinosaurs in the back. Follow me.
Wow, what a lot of stuff.
Yes, it's amazing the things people lose.
Umbrellas.
Handbags.
Pirate treasure.
Wow.
Yes, pirates are always forgetting where they buried their treasure.
People dig the treasure up, and when they can't find the pirate who legally owns it...
they bring the treasure here.
Funny thing is, not one single pirate has ever walked into our police station to claim their treasure.
This cement mixer was found in a train. The passenger must have forgotten it.
Ooh.
And this banana was found in a shoe shop.
How in the world it got there, we'll never know. I'm sorry, young lad. What were we looking for again?
Dinosaur.
Oh, yes. Here we are, a box full of plastic dinosaurs.
Is this your Stegosaurus?
No.
How about this Triceratops?
No.
This Brontosaurus?
No.
Hmm, I'm afraid that's all the toy dinosaurs we've got.
Oh.
Don't worry, George. I'm sure you'll find your dinosaur.
All you've got to do is keep your ears and eyes open. Oh.